Welcome to SSV IIT classes. I am Basha, faculty of Maths. So, we are going to discuss about the analytical geometry, 8th class. In previous class, we discussed about the section formula and centroid based formulas. Now, we are going to find some centers on triangle ABC. So, there are 5 types of centers in triangle ABC. If we know 3 vertices A, B, C, and the length of BC is denoted by small a, means BC is equal to small a, and AB is equal to small c, and AC is equal to small b, which are the lengths of the three sides. The first of all, centroid, end center, excenter, orthocenter, circumcenter. These are the centers which lies in a triangle. First of all, we are going to discuss about the centroid. Already we wrote a condition on centroid in previous class. So centroid is denoted with the capital G. The intersection of medians in a triangle is known as a centroid. For example, let us ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle, and the median means a line segment which is drawn from vertex to midpoint of opposite side. Let us take D is the midpoint of BC. By joining AD, AD is the median in triangle ABC, and another median, say midpoint of AC, E, midpoint of AB, F. By joining BE and CF, we will get a 3 medians, AD, BE, CF. The concurrent point of 3 medians is known as centroid. Centroid is denoted with G. Concurrent point. Concurrent means 2 or more lines which intersecting at one point is known as a concurrent point, and these lines are said to be concurrent lines. Then if we know the vertices x1, y1, x2, y2 and C, x3, y3. Then the centroid formula is Z is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. Already we discussed this one in previous class. So this is the formula for finding the centroid if they give 3 vertices. Centroid G divides each median or every median in the ratio 2:1. 2:2 means AG, GD, AG 2, GD 1, 2:1, 2:1, 2:1. This is about the centroid. By taking examples, we will find the centroid of the triangle. The next one is end center. Second one, end center. What is a end center? End center means in triangle ABC, A, B, C, the intersection of the angular bisectors. Angular bisectors means angle A bisector, angle B bisector, angle C bisector, means the line which was making angle A into two equal parts. Angle A bisector, angle B bisector, angle C bisector. So the concurrent point of angular bisectors in a triangle, which are internal angles, is called as a end center. The end center is denoted with capital I. Capital I. We know already the length of BC is small a, length of AC is small b, small c. So after finding the small a, b, c values, we will substitute the end center formula. End center I is equal to AX1 plus BY1, AX1 plus BX2 plus CX3 by A plus B plus C, comma AY1 plus BY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 by A plus B plus C. So by using this formula, we will find the end center value of a triangle. If, for example, observe here, we have an example, based on this condition, let us take A 0, 0, B 5, 12, C 16, 12. First of all, we want to find the small a, b, c values, means the length of the sides. Small a means b, c, distance between b and c. B, c, formula is square root of x2 minus x1 whole square, which is known as distance formula, y2 minus y1 whole square. That is equal to square root of b, c, x2 minus x1, 16 minus 5, whole square plus 12 minus 12 by 2 minus y1, 12 minus 12, which gives us 0 result. 16 minus 5 means 11, 11 square plus 0, 11, 11 means we will get 11. And similarly B, B is equal to AC, A and C, these two values, square root of this one x1 y1, x2 y2. AC means 16 minus 0 whole square plus 12 minus 0. That is equal to 16 square plus 12 square. Then 16 are 256 plus 144. That is equal to 256 plus 144. 400. Square root of 400 value 20. Then C is equal to AB. AB means distance between A and B. X1 y1, x2 y2. So then 5 minus 0 whole square, x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1 plus 12 minus 0 whole square. Then finding the value, 5 minus 0 means 5 square plus 12 square. That is equal to 5 5 25 plus 12 12 144. 25 plus 144 169. Square root of 169 value 13. So small c is equal to 13 units. After finding ABC values, substituting in central formula, I is equal to AX1 BX2 CX3 by A plus B plus C, AY1 BY2 plus CY3 by A plus B plus C. Already we know X1, Y1 values here, ABC values. By substituting A value, A is equal to 11. 11 into X1, X1 value 0, plus B, B value 20. 20 into X2, X2 value 5, plus C value 13. 13 into X3, 16, by A plus B plus 3. 11, 20, 30, come on. The second coordinate, y coordinate, a into y1, 11 into 0 plus 20 into y2, 12 plus c, 30 into y3 means 12 by a plus b plus c, 11 plus 20 plus 30. So by simplifying it, we get 11 into 0, 0, plus 25 is 100, plus 13, 16 is 16, 10 is 160, 16, 3 is 48, 160, 208, by 11, 20, 31, 34, 44, comma, 0, plus 20 12 is 240, plus 30 12 is 144, plus 12 146, 166 by 40. So then simplifying it, 208 plus 100, 308 by 44, comma, 240 plus 150, 240, 100, 340, 340 plus 56, 396 by 44. So cancellation, 444, 44 5s are
11
11 4s are 11 2s are 22 11 8s are 88 here also 11 4s are 44 11 3s are 33 11 6s are 66 we will get 28 by 4 36 by 4 4 1s are 4 7s are 4 1s are 4 9s are then the coordinates are 7 comma 9 which gives us in center I is equal to 7 comma 9 this is about the end center we have 5 centers in a triangle and first one is centroid by using the x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3 we will find the centroid which divide the each median in the ratio 2 is to 1 and the next one is in center which is known as congruent points of angular bisectors in a triangle this gives the formula so this is the one more example first of all we want to find the small abc values which are known as the three sides of a triangle by substituting x1 y1 and abc values we will get the end center value thank you next video we are going to discuss about the x center and ortho center